money. Nicki Minaj, Justin.
Show you off. Tonight I wanna show you off. What you got? A billion could never buy.
First up, on our final show before the seniors leave, Chloe Mills speaks out to our soon-to-be graduates and reflects on their time here. Then, our favorite weather boy, Joey Macdonald, is back with his final forecast.
Then, Jay Cahn updates us on Broadway's plans to reopen, and Jullys Souza gives us some much-needed song recommendations.
Finally, Colby Beck has all the need-to-know information surrounding the Massachusetts reopening plan, including what you can look forward to as soon as this Saturday. And Andrew Reynolds covers Boston and Framingham High sports.
All that and more on this episode of Flyer News Remote. And welcome back to Flyer News Remote. Today is Monday, May 24th, day 7 with periods running ABCD. I'm Katie Knox.
And I'm Mr. G. You know, Katie, this being your last week of high school, I'm really going to miss having the seniors here.
Thanks, Mr. G. I'm sure going to miss being here. I've learned so much from Framingham High, and I'm so thankful for my time here. It's truly been a blast.
No doubt, Katie. Chloe Mills sat down with a few seniors to reflect on their experience at FHS to have some advice for the underclassmen.
Let's hear what they've got to say.
As we know, this week is the last week that our seniors here at FHS have of high school. And goodbyes can be really hard, especially when you're saying them to people or a place that you've known for a really long time. So this week, I talked with some of our outgoing upperclassmen about their high school experience and what they're looking forward to after.
What are you looking forward to most for life after high school?
I'm looking forward to like being on my own. I've been pretty independent for the last 4 years, and I feel like now finally being able to move out of my house and being on my own, it's really going to open a lot of doors for me, and I'll have a lot more freedom, and I'm really looking forward to that.
Honestly, it's just a little bit of freedom. Slowly but surely throughout grade school, you get a little bit more. Now I get a taste of the real world, so I kind of just want to see how that goes. See where that takes me.
After high school, I'm really looking forward to independence, being the one to like set my own daily schedules, make sure I'm taking care of myself, and just seeing me excel because of me, not like necessarily as much help or like nurture or guidance.
I'm looking forward to going to college and having my own place pretty much when I live on a dorm, so that'll be pretty exciting.
I'm looking forward to going to college with my friends.
I'm most looking forward to the things that like I want to do and studying the things that I want to do, like education. I'm looking forward to learning how to help the next generation and hopefully becoming a teacher.
How have you felt you've changed since your freshman year?
I feel like I discovered myself a lot in high school, and just being more honest with myself and being who I am instead of who other people want me to be.
I feel less introverted and more outgoing.
A lot of my freshman year was trying to fit in, find different, you know, things people did, try to figure out how to fit in. Eventually you learn to just stop caring and just be yourself, and people start to follow you rather than you following everyone else.
Since my freshman year of high school, I think I've definitely matured and like learned to prioritize in school, and not only like schoolwork and like homeworks and stuff, but also balance personal and school life. Like school isn't always everything, and just trying to have like a whole happy, like healthy life.
I did not know anyone I had just moved to Framingham right before, like August before ninth grade started. So I literally like didn't know anyone. I wasn't sure what to expect. And I've made so many friends here, and I've learned so much. I've had so many amazing experiences. And I think my whole outlook on life has really changed for the better. And I'm really excited for what's to come.
I felt that I was very innocent then, and high school changed people in a lot of ways, so I've lost that innocence, I guess.
What is one piece of advice you'd want to pass on to incoming high schoolers?
I would say find a solid group of friends freshman year, but just so you're warned, the friends do fade away. They don't always stick around, so find a couple real ones and you'll be set for the rest of the year.
That the teachers here care about you and want you to succeed in their class.
Leave middle school behind. Anything you've done there, just wash your brain. Come into high school with a mindset that you just want to literally avoid your life that you did in middle school, because a lot of it's immature. Come to school, don't act like you're above everyone else. Just do your part like everyone else.
Enjoy it and join the track team. And really try hard in the things that you want to do. Explore things and try to meet new people and talk to a bunch of people, because there's nothing really to lose.
I'd say don't be afraid to try new things. High school has so many opportunities. Just be free. If you're interested in it, why not give it a shot? There's really no penalty for trying new things. So long as they're legal, obviously. And it's just, you never know what you're gonna like. I was an athlete in middle school. I played softball, I did all these sports, and then I came here and I kind of stopped doing that. And that's when I got into Flyer News, and it's been like the best thing to happen to me. I absolutely have loved my time in the program. So really, you never know what's gonna come out of trying anything. So highly recommend.
I think for freshmen, it's super, super important to utilize all the resources you're given. So like reach out to your guidance counselor, join clubs, join sports, anything you can get involved in, like the more the merrier. It's really gonna help you feel more comfortable in your high school experience and feel like you have more help, because you do have all that help. It's so worth it being friendly to teachers and getting to know everybody. So I think just being outgoing out of your comfort zone is the best thing you can do for yourself.
And what will you miss most about FHS?
I think I'm actually going to miss my teachers and my friends the most. I feel like there's an amazing community at FHS, and I really couldn't have done it without like the confidence and the help and the guidance and like getting cheered on by everybody. So I'm really going to miss that community of like inclusiveness and diversity.
Definitely seeing my friends every day. Now I'm going to meet a lot of new people, but there's some bonds here that I just don't want to break. And it's sad that they're going to be gone soon.
Without a doubt. The track team and all my friends that I've met here and my coaches. I really, really love this program, and it really hurts that I'm not going to be on this next year. But definitely just my friends and my team and this sport, I'm going to miss most.
Something I'll miss most about FHS is Flyer News. They're pretty much my second family. I've lived here for 4 years, and it's a fun experience.
I will miss people on Flyer News and meeting all the new friends that I've made over the past 4 years.
That's really hard. I'm gonna miss a lot. I'm gonna miss a lot after leaving, to be honest with you, because I just love this school so much. I feel like not a lot of people fully appreciate FHS, but I really, really just am so appreciative of my time here. I think most I'm gonna miss hanging out in TV every day. You know, that's really been like a home for me. I essentially live there. I stay after school every day. I've had so much fun with everyone in the program. Like, we're all like a family. So I think more than anything, I'm really gonna miss being in Flyer News.
Congratulations to our class of 2021. I'm Chloe Mills, and let's go back to Katie and Mr. G at the desk.
Last week was sure a hot one, but these AC units are really coming in handy now.
I don't know what we did without it. Of course, Joey's killer weather forecasts are always super handy when planning the week's outfits.
With what to expect for this week, Joey Macdonald has his last weather.
Morning. Today's forecast calls for blue skies. welcome back to my final installment of weather. My name is Sean Macdonald. Let's take a look at one final forecast. So Monday, looking about a high 72, a low of 50, gonna be a partially cloudy day. Tuesday, it's gonna be a little warmer, high 77, low 48, partially cloudy day yet again. Wednesday, it's gonna spike up with heat, high 90, low 61, partially cloudy yet again. Thursday, a little cooler but still very hot, high of 84, low of 55, partially cloudy day yet again. As we're rolling to Friday, it's gonna be a lot cooler, high of 63, low of 48, it's gonna be a pretty rainy day. Saturday, it's gonna be a little better, high of 64, low of 45, it's only supposed to be a cloudy overcast day, so we're not supposed to see any rain that day. And to end off the week, we're gonna have a nice cool, high of 66, low of 48, partially cloudy day. So, we still got some nice hot weather coming in with a little cool days to give us a little bit of a break. That's it for me. Thank you, FHS. Let's take it back to the desk.
The United States has spoken out recently against China due to their continued use of concentration camps. The concentration camps are located in the Xinjiang region. The United States has spoken out recently against China due to their continued use of concentration camps. The camps are located in the Xinjiang province and are used for China's Muslim population, known as Uyghurs. Former Secretary of State Mike Pompeo said in 2019 that those detained there were, quote, being treated in ways that are fundamentally inconsistent with what China would have you believe, end quote. Speaker Pelosi and other House members are now calling on other countries to boycott the 2022 Winter Olympics, which are planned to be held in Beijing. 85% of China's cotton is produced in the Xinjiang region, an integral ingredient in the production of clothing, and many are now calling for a boycott of Nike and H&M, who outsource their clothing production to China. Flyer News will continue to inform you as the story progresses. Broadway has just recently announced that they'll be reopening soon. And while taking a trip to New York isn't likely for me in the near future, this no doubt is a big win for the theater community.
With more on Broadway's reopenings, we have Jay Cahn.
Broadway is finally reopening. That's right, we can look forward to incredible performances like...
I believe that the Lord God created the universe. I believe that he sent his only son to die for my sins.
Wow, Broadway performers are amazing. Broadway has been shut down since March at the beginning of COVID-19 quarantine. The COVID shutdown of Broadway marks only the fourth time that Broadway was forced to shut down since it took New York by storm. The first shutdown was a result of the 9/11 attack in 2001. The second closing came in 2003 with the stagehand strike, and the third moratorium took place during a musician's strike. The coronavirus has taken a toll on the community members in and around Broadway. Actors who finally received their big break as a Broadway star have been forced to wait nearly a year to be back on stage. Restaurants and businesses in Times Square have suffered economically due to the decline in visitors who would normally come to see Broadway productions. In fact, as of October 2020, New York lost nearly $15 million in Broadway and business incomes due to the pandemic closures. However, the September reopening brings hope for the actors and businesses that revolve around the success of Broadway. We actually have a little bit of Broadway coming to our schools on May 28th and 29th at 8 p.m. with Shrek the Musical. The musical will be performed live for a limited audience at the Memorial Garden outside of the school. But if you can't get tickets to see the show live, then you can watch the production through livestream. I've seen the outdoor stage and some of the set for the musical, and it looks really cool. Also, as Broadway reopens, you can head to New York to see Hamilton, The Lion King, Wicked, and more. I guess you could say that the sun will come out tomorrow for Broadway. This has been Jake Cahn bringing you the scoop on Broadway's reopening. That's a wrap.
In recent Framingham news, a 38-year-old man was found with serious injuries in the back of a garbage truck on Friday the 14th. On Winter Street, a live camera records the inside of the trash portion, revealing that the man was dumped there. It is not known if the man got into a dumpster on his own or if he was pushed there. Chief Sean Riley assumes that while looking for an item he recently dropped, the man went into the dumpster, and then the dump truck came and picked him up. The truck stopped on Route 9 after the driver pulled over immediately when he discovered that what has happened. The 38-year-old man was then flown to Boston Medical Center by a rescue helicopter soon after the incident. The man suffered a bunch of injuries with cuts, bruises, but he will survive. When I was admittedly skeptical of Jullys' recommendation when it came to music at first, it's no laughing matter, he knows his stuff.
That's for sure. Jullys just hooked me up with some great playlists to listen to in the coming weeks.
And with so much music being released nowadays, it's hard to keep track of which artists are dropping and when.
So without further ado, let's hear from Jullys about the newest drops and the best songs to start listening to on repeat.
Good morning, FHS.
Good morning, FHS.
Good morning, FHS.
Good morning, FHS.
Morning, FHS.
Good morning, FHS.
Good morning, Framium.
What's going on, Framium?
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 And what's going on, Framium? My name is Jullys, and this is the last episode of J Jams. Slow down. First up for our last episode, we have a brand new album by 21 Pilots. It's called Scaled and Icy, so let's check it out. That song was called Saturday, and in my opinion, it was one of the best songs of the album. The rest of the songs sounded very techno and electronic, and sometimes it's just not what I'm feeling. And when I listened to the album, I wasn't feeling it because it just didn't really sound good. But this Saturday song sounded really good. It was definitely one of my favorites. I added it to my personal playlist, so that's why I'm recommending it to you. Over the weekend, Anson Seaber released 3 songs, so let's check one of them out.
So let the butterflies free if your eyes meet for a moment. And when she finally leaves, it's like she's walking in slow motion.
That song was called Magazines, and if you're building a sad playlist, I definitely recommend that you put that in there because it fulfills all the requirements of a sad song. Very slow paced, which sometimes I like, but most of the time it's like, whatever. But yeah, I really like that song and definitely gonna be adding it to one of my playlists. And the last song I'll be recommending to you is a single by Vance Joy, so let's take a listen.
Finally make it home, because when I'm in a room with you, that missing piece is found.
That song was called Missing Piece by Vance Joy, and without this segment in my life, I will definitely be having a missing piece. It's definitely a really good song. It's upbeat. The lyrics are a little sad, but for the most part, it's more of a happier song. But yeah, that's all I have for this episode of J Jams. Let's send it back to our anchors. J Jams out.
The English royal family has recently spoken out against the BBC following the conclusion of BBC's investigation into the infamous Princess Diana interview from November 1995. The interview became famous after Princess Diana exposed her marital issues with Prince Charles. According to a Time magazine article on the topic, BBC's investigation concluded that BBC journalist Martin Bashir had, quote, falsified documents to gain access to Diana, end quote. An original investigation by BBC soon after the interview in the 90s concluded that Bashir had fairly secured the interview. However, the 25th anniversary of the interview last year caused questions to arise once more. The United Kingdom government is now reevaluating its relationship with BBC and its funding by taxpayers. I still remember last March like it was yesterday. Our field trip to WCVB5 was one of the last normal experiences we had before the world shut down.
Luckily, Massachusetts has been killing it in the vaccine game, and Governor Baker has finally announced Massachusetts' new plan to returning back to normal.
Massachusetts COVID restrictions are drastically shifting this Saturday, and with such a short timeline with so many changes, it's important to know what to expect next week when everything changes.
With new updates on the mask requirements, capacity limitations, and just other guidelines, we have Colby Beck with the scoop.
As of last week, May 17th, the Baker-Polito administration announced that the Commonwealth of Massachusetts would lift all remaining COVID-19 restrictions on May 29th. This includes the Massachusetts face covering order that will also be rescinded. The Massachusetts Department of Public Health will issue a new face covering advisory consistent with the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention's update. Face coverings, however, will still be required for all individuals on public and private transportation and in healthcare facilities. However, the administration will update face covering requirements for youth and amateur sports and other programs in K-12 schools. Massachusetts is able to move forward because the Commonwealth is on track to meet the goal of over 4 million residents vaccinated by the first week of June. As of last week, over 4 million residents have received the first dose, with 3.2 million full vaccinated people. According to the Framingham source, new cases have dropped by 89% since January 8th. COVID hospitalizations are down 88% since January 1st, and the positive test rate is down by 88% from peaking at 8.7%. That's all for me. Let's take it back to the anchors.
Birmingham High sports teams have really been killing it this week. Players are doing great, especially our own Chloe Mills.
You're certainly right, Mr. G. I heard both the girls and boys track and field teams won on Wednesday in one of their last races of the season.
And given the sports schedule change due to the pandemic, we have the most active sports we've ever had.
Andrew Reynolds' in-depth coverage of all things Framingham Flyers, as well as the important information surrounding Boston sports.
Let's hear it, Andrew.
Good morning, welcome back to Sports Desk. I am your host, Andrew Reynolds. A lot of stuff happened over this past week, so let's get right into it. Let's start off with Flyer Sports. On Monday, the softball team took the W against Braintree with a final of 10-4. Senior captain Olivia Lincoln went 4-for-4 on the day. On Tuesday, the boys lacrosse team took a devastating loss to Newton North with a final score of 10-9. That game gave the team an overall record of 3-2 on the season. On Wednesday, the Flyers boys and girls track and field team beat Milton with a final score of 78-58 on the girls' side and 83-48 on the boys' side. They earned themselves their first win of the season at Bowditch. Also getting their first win of the season on Wednesday was the girls' tennis team. They beat Weymouth High with a final of 5-0. Freshman Jordan Satiski, sophomore Marianne Foy, and Christina Avila won their matches in the singles. And in the doubles, junior duos Ella Downing and Natalie Alakian and Olivia Romito and Mae Cable also won their matches. Now let's head over into the world of Boston sports. The Bruins started round one in the playoffs against the Capitals last Saturday night. As of Sunday, game five is tonight, and the Bruins are in control of the series with a 3-1 lead. On Monday, the Bruins came out on top with a 4-3 win in OT. Then on Wednesday, the Bees came back to Boston to play their first playoff game at home since the Game 7 loss to the St. Louis Blues in the 2019 Stanley Cup Finals. The Bruins ended up winning their second straight game in the series by taking that game in double OT with a final of 3-2. The Bruins are looking hot right now, and if they win the series against the Caps, they will be playing either the Pittsburgh Penguins or the New York Islanders. The Celtics on Tuesday night beat the Wizards with a final of 118-100 to move on to the official NBA playoffs. The Seas started round one of the playoffs against the Brooklyn Nets on Saturday night. They are currently losing in the series 1-0 after a loss to the Nets on Saturday that ended with a final of 104-93. They play tonight and try to tie the series at one apiece. In the Red Sox last three games, they are 3-0. On Thursday, they beat the Blue Jays with a final of 8-7. Then on Friday, they started a three-game series against the Phillies and won both games. In the first game, they won with a final of 11-3. And then on Saturday, they won with a final of 4-3. They started a two-game series against the Braves on Tuesday and a three-game series against the Marlins on Friday night. Before we end this edition of Sports Desk, big shout out to the seniors that will be ending their high school career at the end of the week. The seniors, especially from Flyer News, mean the absolute world to me, and I've become super close to them. and I hope nothing but the best for them in the future. That's all for Sports Desk this week. Reporting for Flyer News, I'm Andrew Reynolds. That's a wrap.
That's all for this episode, as well as my run as producer of Flyer News Remote.
It's sure been fun. Congratulations to you and all the seniors on graduating.
Thanks so much. Be sure to check out our Instagram at Framingham High Studios for behind-the-scenes photos, and thank you for a great 4 years, FHS.
Have a great day, Flyers.